Jay Shrek, hey, you wouldn't believe where we're at today. We just signed in to Sears Point, and I'm telling you that Sears Point is one of the most spectacular places, fairly easy to get to, about 8.5 miles off Spot Road. And one thing you're going to find out once you get here is that you're going to get into petroglyphs immediately. On both sides right here, you're going to be in petroglyphs. And some of the most spectacular petroglyphs that you're going to run into anywhere in the state of Arizona or at this very location, and very accessible. You do got to climb that ridge line. Now, one thing about Gila Bend, if you're familiar with it, they all have that same about 3-story plateaus above where the water ran through, like where we're at. You know, the Butterfield Stagecoach actually ran through here as well. So this place has unbelievable history. And I'll tell you what, we're going to get right on it because you don't have to go very far, right? All you have to do is walk from that area right there, right to right up here. And all of a sudden, you're in the middle of some of the greatest petroglyphs you're ever going to see. You look up on that ridge right there, and I'm going to tell you automatically that you're going to see petroglyphs right there. Now, how many places can you go and immediately get into ancient history? How incredible is that? Unbelievable. Unbelievable. This is unreal that we're here today, and we're going to take you along because we're going to do a little Black Flag Adventure Group out here, because it's a great place for you to get your feet wet if you're not familiar. Now, you will need a high clearance vehicle and probably not a great place to go if it happens to rain, but really not bad at all. And like I said, about 8.5 miles, and you can start anywhere. You can start right up here because you're going to get into petroglyphs all across here, and you can even jump up here and get into petroglyphs right here. And then there's trails, there's a racetrack, there are sleeping circles, there are everything at this location that you could ever want that gets into ancient culture, and we're going to get into it right now. You know, there's not a lot of places you can go to where you can get right outside of your car, kind of be in the middle of nowhere, because we kind of are. You can take a couple trails either that direction and or this direction right from the car, and you get right into petroglyphs. I mean, there's a trail we're going to take, fairly steep, so I'm not going to tell you it's going to be super, not super easy. You got to do a little walking, you got to get a little energy going, but what you're going to be amazed at is the amount of petroglyphs you're going to be able to see that quickly. Well, we've taken the first little climb up the hill. We've already hit a petroglyph. And then there's kind of a trail that goes along the edge of the rock face. And I'm going to work our way around to take a look. Many ways that you can get up here. What a beautiful valley. Just a gorgeous place. Got a lot of wind today, which kind of is good. Now, one thing I'm going to caution you. Let's say you're just fresh at starting to explore ancient ruin sites, petroglyph sites. The thing to remember is this. There are going to be bees on these walls somewhere. Somewhere along this cliff face, we're going to run into bees. So be careful, because the problem is you don't have escape routes if you get into them. And they will attack you, and they will sting the hell out of you. I'm living proof of that. Now, that being said, so there's the car right there. See it? And then look here. All of a sudden, you're going to see one of the most spectacular panels right here that close. How incredible is that? Look at that man right there with big hands, big feet. Look at the dancing something. I don't know what they're dancing. There's a snake. Look at all these designs that are up on this wall. How special does this place have to be able to have all this right here? And look at that view they would have had. And you know what? Take out those buildings over there, which is pretty easy to do in your mind. And this would have looked pretty much the exact same way that it looked 1,000 years ago, with the exception of probably a hell of a lot more water. Now, as we go through here and we look at these designs, you just don't get walls this cool, this fast, in a lot of places. Look at these. Tell me this isn't just beautiful. I mean, it is absolutely unbelievable that these even exist. And they're right here, and they're easily obtainable in the site. Very spectacular. Just beautiful. Just beautiful. And this wall must have meant a hell of a lot, because look at all this that are right here. There's some very ancient stuff with that checkerboard up there. There's a man right up here. And look at this. This automatically, look how you get this so fast. And these are really incredible designs. How unbelievable. Sears Point is a very special place. Now, if you go down here, look on that rock. That one's filled with petroglyphs too. So, you know, we know one thing, that they stayed here. There's a lot of years of habitation here. And look there, that's a pretty rare. That looks like some type of a, there's a bow and arrow. I don't know how old that is, but that would be newer than the rest of this. And looks almost like a wagon up there. You see a guy, it's like a stagecoach. And that's pretty incredible in itself. As we walk through here, we just see the abundance. Now, we're going to make sure that we're keeping our eyes. I get so locked into these petroglyphs that I forget that I need to be looking for bees. They are here. And I need to be careful. But look at this. Look how automatically you get this satisfaction of. You know, I just did a live feed and let everybody know what was kind of in store if they came out here. And, you know, hoping you get to come out and see this place. It's really an unbelievable location. It's fairly accessible. You know, just respect it as we do all. I mean, I expect everybody on this channel to do that. And anybody that's a member of Black Flag, part of what we do is make sure that we take care of what we've got. And, you know, our goal out here is to make sure that this becomes a monument. And we have some protection, some extra protection, but not to shut it down. You know, it's not the goal for this is to preserve, not to prevent. So that's what our goal is, to be able to preserve it. Now, you get up here and you can see areas where they were at. You can see areas where the trails run through here. And it is, Sears is just an incredible place. One of my favorite stuff to look at here is actually a lot of the pioneer stuff. You know, when I think of those, the 49ers that came through here and went on their journey. And you get out here also, you can see these areas that have definitely been cleared. And they are locations where they would have stayed up in here. And you get down in here, you see that circle down there. Most likely is a sleep circle where they would sleep while they're taking these trails. And these trails are up to 8,000 years old. Can you imagine that? 8,000 years old people were coming through here. And what an incredible place. Again, Sears Point is one of my favorite locations. Now, the thing about it is there are petroglyphs that run the entire distance. You know, we've only showed you just a small amount of petroglyphs that are really close, but as you see, there's trails that run all the way around these edges, and there are literally petroglyphs all the way around this location. I mean, all the way through here. So this has always been one of my favorite places, because it's a great place to get your feet wet if this is something that you enjoy doing, because you get a bunch of, but you have big bang for your buck here. And my goal is to make sure that these locations are always available for your children as well as mine, and that they never get shut down. So I don't care what point you look at, right through here, you're gonna see petroglyphs. And they go all the way around this point. And there's petroglyphs on that point over there as well. So, you know, they're all over here. This group that was here, you know, they were a large quantity of people, and they were here for a long time. You can tell by the amount of petroglyphs that are here. And you can also see the different errors. So Sears Point is absolutely a spectacular place. Very incredible place. So we're going to take a look down here just to show you how much stuff is actually here that you can get into very quickly. So if you're looking through here, look at this nice little trail here. So you go along here, and then all of a sudden, no matter where you go in Sears Point, signs of ancient cultures are everywhere. Now, making sure that you keep an eye out for bees, because we know they're here. JG in 48, and I'm going to guarantee you that's probably not 1948, that's probably 1848. You can see petroglyphs all along these rocks. It's that panel right there on that large rock that's facing out. Didn't matter where you went, you would run into to the work. It's all over this area. So you'll take a trip up this hill. Place to get in and get out right there. Nice work on that rock down there. You know, the thing about the culture of Gila Bend is that there was a large amount of people that came through. Now, imagine you were J. Frank on February 4th, 1889, and just think about him sitting on this rock right here. I mean, can you imagine? 1849, man, what was happening in 1849? How about the 49ers, you know? Here's a guy sitting on this rock right here. Sit right on this rock, right where we're at. And was heading to California for the gold rush. You know, and all the dreams and everything that he thought about when he's sitting on this rock of the fact that, you know, what's gonna happen. And you know, if you think about it, that's like 170 years ago. That's quick math, but roughly. But, you know, 150 years ago, a guy was sitting on this rock. You know, 800 years ago, an ancient was sitting here. 1,000 years ago, maybe 8,000 years ago, they were running this ridge. And it just is incredible to me to think about that. Think about their lives and their dreams as they pass through 3, 4, 5, 10, 20 generations of ancients and generations of Euro-Americans and... incredible. It's just incredible history here. And if you just sit down on these rocks and realize that, you know, somebody was sitting on this very rock And maybe in 150 years, somebody will say, hey, you remember that lunatic that was down there on Black Flag? And that'd probably be me. And what was he thinking about? What was he thinking about his journey? Probably the same thing, you know. You want health, you want welfare, you want life to be good, right? You know, you want your children to be protected, you want opportunity to make a living. I mean, I don't think it changed. I think that's the same thing the ancients wanted 1,000 years ago, you know. They wanted a good life, and it's incredible. And the journey, you know, the land might change to some degree. You know, when I look out there, I'll bet right out there you would have saw just this fascinating river that was flowing and the wildlife that was in there. You know, what an incredible place. And that's why this has got to be saved. So J. Frank, on February 4th, 1889, I was way off. So it's 31 years. So 131 years. Intense. I'm going to tell you that already. It is intense. So wear good sunglasses. I said that about 1,000 times. And, you know, I just imagine all the ancients sitting around these rocks, you know, with the fire going. And living their lives here. It's just an incredible place. I can't help but every time I come here, be in awe of this area. Now, I have found shards here. They're extremely rare. And the ones I found probably hadn't been moved since they were dropped. So it was pretty incredible and fairly rare to see, because I've not seen very many. Now, I've done a lot of videos. Not a lot, but I did a couple on Sears. So if you want to get a more intensive look at Sears, then I've got other ones, and I'll try to link them up. But this was more of just a journey just to try to make sure that we got set up for the for two things. We're going to do a meetup out here, and then this is a great place to get, like I said, get your feet wet into ancient exploring without really getting into massive miles of hiking, which will come next, okay? Because then to get to the elite places, you know, you got to do the work. You got to have the vehicle, you got to have the clothing, you got to have the stuff, right? But this is a quick, easy way. This, you know, I won't say it's a completely friendly family friendly, I should say, because man, there's places you could fall, even here. So make sure you're cautious. But wow, what an unbelievable place to get to come see. And like I said, if you want to know more, you want to see more, we did really extensive videos on this place and a lot of the other stuff. But, you know, if you want to get your feet wet and get out a little farther out of town, this is definitely the place that you should go. I'll give you one more quick look of what you're going to see here. Sears Point. Hey, I want to thank everybody that donates to the channel on Tuesday Night Live. So if you like to talk about the ancients and history, all kinds of things like that, 7 o'clock on YouTube, on the YouTube channel, we have a live show. And we've got a pretty good following of loyal people that like doing this. And that's kind of what this is about, is hooking up people that have like-minded interests and getting us all out in the field, the ones that can. I just stepped across this little petroglyph there. Somebody was sitting down there pecking that thing out. One right there. You know, and that's what you get at Sears Point. But again, I want to thank everybody that's contributed to the channel. It's the reason why I get to do this, and it's much appreciated. And if you'd like to subscribe to Patreon, that'd be awesome. Or just watch the channel, share our material out there in your social medias. That's an awesome thing just as well. So this is Jay Schreck on the trail. And here we are. There's the vehicle. There's the old trusty FJ right there. So we're going to work our way back down to the truck. And I'm going to see what's out here. There's Maria down there.